Okay, I'll call to order the Oxford Area Cable Communication Commission meeting for Monday, October 25th, 2021. Can we stand and pay our respects to the flag?
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Roll call.
Here.
Who's doing roll call?
I'll do it.
Aren't you the secretary?
No, I'm the treasurer.
Oh, you're the treasurer. Is Mo the secretary?
Yes, she is.
And she's not here.
I'll take over for a moment.
All right.
Conway, present. Dunn, present. Gable, present.
Here.
Okay, approval of the agenda.
Move to approve.
Second.
Been approved and support, it's motion to approve and support it. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Public comments on items not on the agenda. Seeing none. Item six, the minutes from September 20th and from October 8th.
I'll move to support her for that too.
To receive and file?
Receive and file.
I'll support.
We have a motion. It's been supported. All in favor? Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Bill review. 7A, bill run. That is from pages 7 through 12.
Are you, did you approve both minutes at the same time?
You did.
Oh, sorry.
We did.
Okay, I'm trying to keep notes for Mo.
The bill run is, well, the bill run itself is page 9, I believe.
7 through 12.
Well, we need approval for the expenses for the month on page 9.
So the 28,637 is the bill run for the month. I'll move to approve.
I'll support.
We have a motion and it's been supported. Roll call.
Dunn, yes. Conway?
Yes.
Gable?
Yes.
Motion passes.
Motion passes. 7B. And 7C.
I'll move to receive and file 7A, excuse me, 7B and C.
7B and C to receive and file. We have a motion.
Do we need a motion to approve, not receive and file, or?
A motion to receive and file.
It's a report to receive and file.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I'll support.
It's been, a motion has been made, it's been supported. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed?
I'll move to receive and file Oakland County Investment Pool dated October 1st, 2021.
We have a motion that's been supported. All in favor? Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? 8B, the manager's report.
I don't have one at this time.
What did I read in there?
It's the 3-year plan.
Oh, I know what's up.
Manager's report. So that's Mel and Boyd, unfinished business, Oxford Cable TV's 3-year plan. Terry?
That was a lengthy one, sorry about that. So.
You wanna just give us bullet points?
So sure, we have pretty well so far. Purchased equipment that we needed that was in this 3-year plan, but it was also in what we needed immediately. Everything under our limited amount. So we've gotten lights for cameras, we've gotten tripods. We're still working towards saving money for the bigger equipment purchases. We are looking at, in the next 3 years, we're going to need to replace our TriCaster which could be anywhere up to 20,000. And I want to talk about that during budget discussions. I would like to see us be able to set aside money in our budget that we can see that totaling our three-year plan, so we know where that money's going to go in 3 years. And so that, I think I put, we would be saving a certain amount, 20,000 a year, per year, to go for the purchase of the three-year plan purchases. Earmark.
Money set aside.
Set aside. But I'd like to see a place in our budget.
Easy to do.
Yeah. Somehow it got taken out. We did it at one time. And I'm also familiarizing myself, as I've said before, I wasn't, I didn't work with the budget. I know how to work with a budget. Dave, I've leaned heavily on Dave in the last 2 weeks to get this packet together. So I really want to familiarize myself with the budget, but I know that we don't have any money set aside for what we have in this three-year plan.
I have a question on, I guess it's the third page of the three-year business plan. It's talking about the field cameras are over 8 years old. Mm-hmm. It's like right in the middle there. It says the cameras are estimated to be a cost of, I think it's a typo. So is that supposed to be 1,000?
It's 1,000 each. Yeah, 1,000 sorry
each.
About that.
That's right.
And so far, we've replaced two. Right, Dave?
Yeah.
So I would like to be able to replace all eight by the end of our three-year plan. There's some, so viewfinders right now we're good at. We may have to replace those before the end of our three-year plan on our sports cameras. So I would keep you updated on what we need to replace, like right away, if anything in here goes out.
Could I ask for, I haven't got a clue what a TriCaster is or what a lot of this stuff is. Could you give just some crib notes on what these pieces of equipment do?
Okay, so hang on, that'll take me a second to go through. It's, so as far as our TriCaster is concerned, that's what we have in the studio to record what we do in the studio.
Okay.
It's a computer system. It's old, like 10 years old, the TriCaster. And so again, with computer equipment, they go out of date. We can't update them. And this one we've already had repaired. And we were down for nearly a month or 6 weeks when we had it repaired. And it was because it's out of date and they had to search around the whole country and find the piece that we needed to get us back up and running. So we do need to buy updated equipment. Unfortunately, what we deal with, stuff goes out of date quickly.
The TriCaster, does that mean it supports three cameras?
Mm-hmm. Yes, and audio.
Supports eight cameras, actually.
What?
Supports eight cameras.
It can support eight. It's supporting three right now.
Oh, I was just assuming it does three because of the name TriCaster. I didn't know. I thought Tri is three.
It's Tri meaning like how you upload, like so you can do a stream, you can go hard drive, or you can go actually physically record the data.
It also supports green screen, right?
Yes.
So there's three elements in there somewhere for you.
Yes, yeah, absolutely.
So the reference of why it's a TriCaster, okay.
Could I suggest that we're going to get participation from people that are working, that they come up here to the microphone so people in the audience would have some idea of who's talking? So Joe, would you stop up here?
Come back up, Joe.
I mean, just to be, for the people at home are just going to go, who's talking to you? What the hell are you talking about?
Sorry about that. The TriCaster just meaning you have three sources of recordable data, three different ways that you can record the data that you're actually shooting.
Yeah, okay. You could stay up here probably, maybe.
Don't move.
Don't move.
So also in here, we have tripods, $10,000 each. And I know you've seen we've been purchasing tripods for way less than that. These are studio tripods. They're mobile. And so they are expensive. We bought these probably 20 years ago.
They're hydraulic tripods, so they actually have hydraulic fluid in there to...
Up and down, up, smooth action, bigger cameras. It's just a studio camera. They also have audio cables attached to them. They're a stable, sturdier...
So these are to be used in the studio?
Strictly in the studio.
Strictly in the studio.
Aren't cameras getting smaller?
Not our studio cameras.
Studio cameras are a little different. They're more higher end. Mm-hmm. Like these cameras here are more like a prosumer, something you could buy at Best Buy for like $1,000. Them studio cameras are close to 10 grand each too.
I remember back in the 50s and 60s that, you know, the cameras are as big as Volkswagens.
Right.
We have a number around NBC on it.
So another high priced item in here is our gimbal. And that's for people that are out in the field. And it's to create a sturdier shoot rather than them bound.
Is that the thing that's mounted to the person's body?
Mm-hmm. It's basically a steady cam.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So the gimbal is like kind of like on the drones where it's constantly always leveling itself. That's what the gimbal would be doing for the camera.
So it's for ease of the field photographer and to get a better shot. I mean, it's otherwise you're getting home movie kind of shots and people are getting seasick. But it's also to help teach people that want to go into film and be out in the field to teach them how to get a steady shot. I am going to put my head down and go full force, and that's mentioned in here also, to bring in more interns and more students. I haven't had a lot, come on.
I have background in taking photos.
You're pretty good at it. It's a good start. That's something I'm passionate about. I think that we really need to help educate the community, the kids that are interested. And I really haven't had a lot of time in the past to do that. I did it at Oregon Neighborhood Television. I loved it. We had a lot of success with interns and students. I just brought one in this week, and I want to do more of it. And that the greater equipment we have, the better they are. So far, we've had people move on that are talent and on camera. We have one guy that was camera, and he now works for Channel 7, who's camera. But we want to be, Joe is very involved in film, and I think that that's where kids want to go. And so that's another reason why I'd love to have decent equipment. And we're charged with that. As a public access television station, that's something we've been charged with.
Well, what's the relationship with the school as far as, I thought there was an attempt in the past to try to do some, what's it called that, when the kids work?
Internship.
It's not an internship, but
like a co-op.
Co-op, yeah.
We've approached them. Kids have service learning hours that they have to complete before they're seniors. We've approached them on that. We've approached the school many, many times. And I have to say, in Chaz's defense, who is the video instructor, he's completely overwhelmed and doesn't have the time to create that path with us. And I didn't either. I will. I'll do that.
I was going to say, is there any way you can, or any of this, the TV station can provide him assistance to create that path?
Part of it is, so we've offered an internships, we've offered for them to do service learning, we've offered even to create a video club. Part of it is they need to have a chaperone if it's students doing something after school or transporting. And Chaz just flat out said they can't find somebody that would be willing to do that. Now, that was a couple years ago. He's a little more settled in, and I now have a time to do that. And so, yeah, I'm willing to go talk with him again. We created that path through Tim Throne, and unfortunately, he's leaving. So I think we might have to see how things, the dust settles in January right. with them. But yeah, I'm totally willing to do that. Orion, and I experienced this when I worked at Orion, had a great program for kids, whether it was summer camp or just internship level, high school assistance. It was really great, and I really think that we need to do that here.
That's how I got my start. I volunteered for Community Media Network and just came up on board, and yeah, they gave me a camera and said, hey, here's how you use it, you know. They offered classes, they offered, but it was through them, you know what I mean? The Community Media
Public
Network,
access.
The public access station themselves were the entity, and they were out of Oakland University, and they offered the time to teach people. And there was, like, Mike Bishop was one of my classmates in that class, you know, like, there was people in there that were all levels of education, high, you know, older people, young people. It was, as good, like you said, it's great for the community. It definitely would be. It'd be nice to have some people out here from Oxford come and just, you know, give their time to come shoot some stuff and learn how to do it themselves. You know, that's what it's about. It's enabling the community to be able to do it.
Right. Well, she stipulates that in her 3-year plan, so.
So also in that 3-year plan, I have the generator, and I understand that you spoke with Ron, and I did as well, yeah.
Question on that about sharing the generator with the rest of the building?
Mm-hmm.
That was gonna be my question.
Yeah, I already talked to Ron. Ron actually has the physical generator. He acquired it from a facility within the, I think the township actually.
Might be one of our older ones.
I think it was a deep water or something.
He said, his electrician looked at it and said it's in great shape and it's still very functional. So he was gonna get back to me with the cost to install it, because his people pulled it out wherever it was and hauled it to his storage facility, and they had their electrical contractor look it over, and he said it will supply the entire building, which would make sense to do both the parks or all three, the park and rec, the senior center, and then the TV station. So he was going to check to see the viability of the generator to be able to do that. He thought it was going to be able to do so, and I haven't heard from him since, but.
Yeah, I spoke with him, and he said the contractor was going to get back with him on whether it had enough units or not. And the last thing that I have here are the studio lights. Our studio lights were the very first grant that we got from Fort County, maybe 15, 17 years ago. And they're number one, obsolete again. They're just too hot. There's new kits that are a lot cheaper and a lot easier to run. With these, if they go out, the bulbs are really expensive. They're just yellowing. They're just awful at this point.
The new ones, LEDs?
Yes.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And a lot cheaper.
So they're cheaper to
operate. A lot cheaper to run, yeah.
Mm-hmm. More efficient.
Yeah.
So it just would make sense to replace those.
So Terry, where are we going with this?
So the 3-year plan, I'm showing a total of 63.8, but that's with the generator. So it could be 53.8 that could cost us in the next 3 years if we replaced everything that I have on this list. Again, I would like to see that divided in 3 years, so it'd be 20 something off the top of my head. And we are going to have a budget workshop. I'd like to somehow figure out how we can put that in the budget.
Could we have you or someone come up with a numerical system on which one's the most important?
Yeah.
Which ones we can't do without, and rank them, and then we can just start knocking them off.
Well, I thought that would be discussed and laid out in a budget workshop.
Yeah, budget workshop.
But to have the manager at least know ahead of time,
yeah,
that, you know, we expect it,
right,
to, yeah, be.
I can do that.
So, if you've read the 3-year plan and have no questions.
I'll move to receive and file.
Support.
We have a motion been supported. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? All right. New business, 10A. OCT proposal for acquisition of new equipment, primarily the, what do you call that thing?
The playback system.
Playback system. This is the brains of the TV station, the heart and soul. The biggest concern that Terry and her people have at present. And she has narrowed it down to two different companies. She came back with us with the detailed proposal for both. Terry?
So I initially was leaning towards Cablecast for a couple reasons. I felt Cablecast would have been a little bit less expensive, and Lake Orion uses Cablecast, so I felt I could lean on Ian in Lake Orion, which I could. Telview updated their bid, so it's good for 30 days, and they gave me a bid a long time ago. And it came back less, and I spoke with the gentleman that I initially talked to in Grand Rapids who runs Telview. He's willing to help me out. So I'm just leaning towards Telview. I initially wanted Telview. I saw demonstrations by both companies 2 years ago and initially went, yep, Telview's for us. That looks like an easier system to run. Neither one of them are going to be easy for us to learn it. There's going to be have to be one point person learning these systems. The gentleman that runs Telview day and night, I can get on the phone with him at any time, day or night, and he'll walk me through. So I feel like it's going to be an easier process to learn.
So this is a guy from Grand Rapids. You're talking about the Grand Rapids cable.
Tom Morris, right. Who also is willing to come over here for a fee if we get stuck or if we need more education beyond what Telview will provide.
Is that what the $1,500 per day is?
That's what Telview would provide, $1,500 a day plus transportation expenses from Novi, whereas Tom Morris is willing to come over here from Grand Rapids for a weekend or Monday and Tuesday. He's off on Monday and Tuesday and teach me what I need to know. I'm going to have to be that point person initially to learn this, as well as Connie Miller. So he's willing to, for $1,000 for 2 days.
So $500 a day.
Pretty much, yeah.
A third less than what.
So are you comfortable being this point person, or would someone like Joe be the point person?
Joe would be really good at learning it too, but his skills are needed elsewhere.
Okay.
And he can only work 40 hours a week, you know. Okay. Connie's willing to learn it. And so am I. I mean, I think it would really help for her to have somebody that she could lean on.
Well, you're the manager.
So what is your preference? What do you want the board to approve?
Telview.
And it comes in cheaper than the Cablecast?
Telview's total is, yes, it does, about $5,937 cheaper. That's without purchasing a warranty. Both of them offer warranties beyond, and you can purchase them year by year. Telview offers a one-year warranty on both hardware and software, which I did not get a guarantee from Cablecast. So that made me feel better as well. Total.
Do we have a total?
Yep.
Is it the $33,296.50?
Yes, because I took off, there's two things that we don't need on there. Mm-hmm. So yeah, it's $33,296.50. Now, I do need to tell you, and this is something I realized today, regardless of which system, and this is something also we need to talk about in our budget workshop, both systems will require us to send everything up to a cloud, which is going to be $2,300 a year. And all systems are doing that. I think that it's unavoidable.
So we give that fee with either system that was
yep.
That'd be purchased.
Yep.
I saw the when I was looking at it on my computer screen at home, I have a different Telview quote than what I got in my
you
packet.
You do. And then Dave asked to replace the second quote, that she, the updated quote, with what you had in the packet.
Oh, I'm sorry. This is what all this
That's
is.
That's the additional paper.
Yeah, okay.
Is there any more questions?
33296 is without the extended warranty.
It is a one-year warranty.
It's with the one-year
without the extended warranty.
Oh, correct.
And right. How far out can you extend?
I think we can extend it 5 years out. But
how
I don't
much
have
is
a,
that going to cost?
I don't have a bid on that. She said it's year to year. And so I think it's a different price every year. With Cablecast, I don't remember what they said. Let me find out what Cablecast. Cablecast had a 5-year warranty that was up to $8,000.
That's the $8,000 I saw was Cablecast.
Yeah, okay, it was Cablecast.
So you don't have any information on extended warranty for Teleview?
Not extended, no, sorry. Cablecast warranty per year is $3,200.
Can we buy the warranty
year
after
year.
The fact?
Yes.
I mean, if we okay the 296, we could tell them a month later we'd like a 1 year, 5 year, whatever
well,
warranty.
What are these costs that I see at the end of the Teleview? It says 2 year, 3 year, 4 year, 5 year. I thought that was the extended warranty cost when I read it.
Oh, you're right, it is. I'm sorry, I totally missed that. Yep, so there's this $3,200 for 2 years. So it's still less than what Cablecast is.
So if we go with a 5 year, it's only $1,600?
No.
That's a year, the cost
that's
of the
that's per year.
That's
year.
You gotta add all that up. It's 3227, so you're looking at
9,000.
59.
1, 2,
79. 5, yeah, it's gonna be over 8,000.
8,000.
It's somewhere in the ballpark of what the other one is.
Yep. Sorry, I missed that.
So in order to get the 5 year, we have to tell them up front? Or can we go with the 2 year and then?
We can go with the 2 year and purchase another three.
For 27, and then for your 4, I mean, are you sure about that?
Well, that's what I'm interpreting here. If we get the 2 year, it's 3270. And if we then go to purchase the three, it's 27.5.
My point is, if we tell them after the second year we want to go on with three, it's only $2,700?
Five.
I was rounding.
Yeah.
We're sure about that.
It's per year, though, it says.
It is per year.
Mm-hmm.
So if you want a 5-year warranty, you're going to pay $1,635 per year up to 5 years.
I have a suggestion. Before, you know, we're going to vote to approve this or not, but I'm assuming we're going to vote to approve it, but I don't want to make assumptions, but I would be more comfortable having our attorney negotiate the costs and warranties and all that and put it up, get it all in writing so we know what we have. No? You don't think so?
I mean, it's right here. I don't think they're going to negotiate the cost, but I mean, but it does seem to be right here based on what. Now this, I don't know who wrote this, or this letter that says, hi Denise, a few more questions. Is that you?
Me, yeah.
And this was her response?
Yeah.
The hardware comes with a 1 year warranty at
mm-hmm.
no cost?
Yep.
So, I mean, I'm not sure we need the extra expense of a legal review, but that's just my two cents.
Well, again, it's, we can.
So if you go with the.
Decide what we want to do.
Well, I mean, what are your thoughts on the warranty, Terry? I mean, obviously, it's an expensive investment, so.
So my thought is, if something's going to go wrong, it's going to go wrong within the next 5 years. I would be more comfortable to purchase a warranty right now, right off the bat, the 5-year warranty. And that brings the total up to $41,496.
And what was the 5-year warranty with the other one?
$8,000 more.
I know, but what's the total?
$39 plus $8, $37,234.
With the warranty for Becker?
Yeah, plus 39, I might be at 47-ish.
I mean, in your letter, 47, sorry.
So
47.
Yeah.
Well, there should be a lot more.
Yeah, 6,000 more. Just like initially, 5,000.
Yeah, you said, okay.
750.
So what is your proposal to the board?
To purchase the Telview with the 5-year warranty in the amount of $41,500.
I'll make a motion that we approve the purchase of the Telview system with the 5-year warranty as presented.
Thank you.
For how much?
$41,500. I don't know if that's an exact number. Is it?
Well, it's close enough.
$41,496.50.
Okay. $41,496.
I will second for discussion. All right,
we have a motion, and it's been seconded. Mr. Dunn?
I seconded for discussion.
I thought maybe you had something to discuss.
No, so we could talk about it.
I think we've already discussed it.
I do want to say, I would expect that they'd be able to get this in by December. Ed was asking me about that earlier. Depending on chips, computer chips and parts and et cetera, whether the equipment can make it in on time. We do have equipment also, and I think Denise mentioned it somewhere in all this paperwork, that we could turn in and they would give us a credit for.
Who, Telview?
Mm-hmm. A credit for the old equipment?
Mm-hmm.
Any idea how much that might be?
I don't, because she doesn't know yet what they have to, what we have that's worth saving. They have to look at it.
Is there any benefit to keeping the old equipment for any reason? Or in 5 years?
There might be if I, and I can ask the their technician, there might be a benefit to using that as a backup in case something goes down, if it interfaces with the new equipment. Mm-hmm. I can ask them that, but I doubt it. We could sell it on eBay or take their, giving us a credit.
Yeah, I'm guessing you're better off getting rid of it.
Getting a credit, letting them take it away.
Mm-hmm. Ready for a vote?
Yes, roll call please.
Gaba?
Yes.
Dunn? Yes. Ed?
Yes.
Passes.
Thank you. I'll keep you informed.
Okay, pages 34 and 36, we have budget amendments. I'm assuming you want to move monies around?
Yep. So, Dave, you want to do that?
Yep. We have three areas, cameras and accessories. We had already expensed $6,664 through 10/31. And I was estimating for the remaining expense through the end of the year would be $1,000, which comes out to $7,664. We had budgeted $3,000, so obviously we were way over. So the difference would have been $4,664. And we were recommending a boosting of that particular budget line by $4,800.
Where do we...
Where's it coming from?
Taking it from the wages. It's coming from the hourly wages line item.
We had undershot our hourly wages considerably this year because of the pandemic. And the school especially pulling back on its sports and concerts.
And so the reason we have that overage is that immediate list that I gave you two meetings back, and then you told us to go ahead and purchase the items that were under the $2,500 limit. So we did, and that's where this figure is coming from.
So you want to reduce the wages?
$6,664.
$6,000.
Right.
So anyway, we can have this on the next time we do this. Where it's coming from and how much it is.
Well, she's got it here.
Where's the 6,000?
I don't see a 6,000 either.
What I'm saying is...
On this sheet? Are you looking at this sheet?
Yeah.
I sure am.
6,664 expenses through 10/31.
That's the cameras.
That's everything that we purchased that you told us to purchase.
And your... Dave said there's a difference between what was budgeted and what you've spent of... $4,664.
Right.
I'm showing you want to reduce the hourly by $5,000 and add it, or am I not reading this right?
Right.
That's right.
You want to boost it by $5,000. Or I'm sorry, reduce it by $5,000. Right.
The hourly.
Right.
Hourly.
And apply that to the
accessories.
Accessories.
So it should be $5,000.
Should be $5,000.
Right, where did...
Well, there's another line for trash that we want to boost by 200. Oh. That would bring everything up to 5,000.
Oh, I see. You want to put $200? What's
trash? The 48 plus 40, the 200.
It'll be 4,800 in the cameras and the 200 in the trash.
Yeah, sorry. Yep.
Okay. That makes sense. At least it numbers that up. What is trash?
We split a trash bill with Parks and Recs.
Oh, okay.
And it's higher than we anticipated.
All right, so the proposed amendment changes are increasing the accessories by $4,864.
And we're just rounding it up to $4,800.
Or $4,800. And reducing wages by 5,000 and adding 200 to trash.
Correct.
All right, do we have a motion?
I'll make a motion to amend the budget to, as just stated by you.
Okay.
That's reiterating.
I will second that.
All right, we have a motion that's been supported. Roll call.
Oh, Dunn, yes. Hunley?
Yes.
Gavel?
Yes.
Motion passes.
Thank you.
All right. 10C, the IRS, the employment identification number. This is something that I have them put on the agenda. At our previous meeting, I wanted to discuss the topic of that meeting, which was a special meeting, in closed session for some of it. And I was brought into the Oxford Township offices and the attorney for the township, in his opinion, based on state law, we weren't allowed to go into closed session. Our attorney interpreted the state law and she stated that we were allowed to go into closed session. So there was a conflict between the two attorneys on opinion. And so the township supervisor, Mr. Curtis, him and I talked and with their attorney, and Mr. Curtis's concern is that it involved an employee, and that because we are the TV station employees fall under the township tax ID number, there was concern that the township was exposed to any liability if we were doing something illegal. He said, until we change this, he doesn't want township to be
liable
for anything. He said, if we want to hold an illegal meeting and we are not under their ID number, then he goes, do whatever you want. He said, but while you're under the township ID number, he's insisting, or he insisted to me that his attorney's interpretation of the law has to take precedent.
So his opinion letter is the law, as far as the township is concerned.
Right.
If we're using their tax ID.
Right, so Jack asked me to pursue having us have our own ID number. I contacted our attorney and she can get that whole thing in motion and get it taken care of if the board will approve to have that done. She said it shouldn't take that long. It shouldn't be that big a deal.
Have there ever been any other issues with this board acting under the township, like something that the township thinks isn't right, or
well, I
could, the first time that
I could bring back some old memories.
Well, please.
We had a problem a few years ago, and we had one attorney that was representing Addison, we had one attorney that was also at the village of Oxford, and we had another attorney, so he was doing both. Mm-hmm. And we had our own attorney, and we pretty much said this isn't right, because it's a kind of, well, who does their attorneys represent? Does it represent the townships and the village, or do they does he represent the cable commission? So I insisted we get rid of them.
The attorney.
The attorney.
Yeah.
Okay. I mean, where there's no conflict, because there was, it was kind of holy cow, there was some.
So well, all our main accounts are under the Oxford Township.
Well, Oxford Township. We pay an annual fee for the service, just like you would if you had, was it
paychecks or
DP or whatever they, I forgot the company.
ADP.
Yeah. We pay the service. They handle the bookkeeping and they handle the disbursement of payroll and so forth. We currently are identified by the federal government, the IRS, under the same employment number as a township. And the town, the Parks and Rec was going, had the same identical format that we're doing now. 2 years ago, 3 years ago, they changed and got their own ID number. Because it was recommended that they do so. And now Mr. Curtis is recommending that we do the same. And I support that position. We should be on our own.
Right, it sounds, yeah, like a good, quick, easy thing to do in theory, but if you think outside of it, like you said, so then we have to have our own payroll service. Who's gonna file our taxes?
You can still contract.
No.
That's all contract.
Yeah.
It's all contract.
It's a seamless thing because the township can handle all that and do it
for
us.
We would still
pay the township.
Yeah, we'd still have done. Yeah.
It's actually cheaper. It's a lot cheaper to just hire the township. Mm-hmm. And if Addison or the village of Oxford want to take it over and take it over, you know. We just put our name in where we would do it for a certain price.
Which is,
yeah, the only thing that would,
with that,
yeah,
tax ID number when talk, you started doing that.
Right, the individual that I talked to, and they used the Parks and Rec, the only thing that changed was the ID number. Everything else stayed the same, just the how the payroll was distributed, how the monies were accumulated and dispersed and all that, nothing changed. It's just the ID number. It's just to separate the employees for the TV station from the township.
I make a motion that the Oxford Cable make a move to get their own federal ID number.
To pursue that?
To pursue that.
Through the attorney?
Yep.
And I'll support.
All right, we have a motion that's been supported. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed?
Actually, we're spending money.
Yeah.
Oh, we are spending money. Okay, roll call.
Yes. Battle?
Yes.
Hunwick?
Yes.
Motion passes.
Great.
I have to keep on top of this.
10D, we need to schedule early next month, I would hope, a budget workshop. Any interested parties, individuals?
Does the whole board need to do it, or?
No, I was just hoping it would be a board member and Terry.
I would rather just have the cable people bring a proposed budget to the next meeting. And the budget isn't that big of a deal, we could either approve it or...
You don't think it's a good idea to sit down and discuss some of the items that they may bring and maybe...
But even at the township, when I did all the budgets, I would present the budget. We would present to the board, and we wouldn't go line by line, we'd go section by section. Does anybody see any problem with these numbers for this section? Nothing, move on. And we just go through it, and you just correct it like that.
You didn't do workshops? You didn't do workshops at all?
We don't either.
Nope.
But when do we have to vote on the budget? Because we'll say, oh, December? Oh, so we would only, well, we would give us next month.
So next month, let's, you guys present your budget to us, and we will take a few minutes and go through it, you know, section by section, and either approve it or make suggestions and vote on it to move money around, or then we can vote on that, and then, or we can send it back to the manager in December meeting, present it to us to vote on.
Are you making a motion?
I did.
I'll support that.
Oh, that's a motion?
Yes.
All right.
I figured out.
It's a motion, it's been supported. All right, I'll go on. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed?
Sound reasonable?
Yeah, if it's gonna simplify the process, I don't care. I just figured we needed to put a workshop together.
Nah.
Okay. All right, Tenny, the employee handbook, it was updated or modified to include what?
Well, it had to do with specific conduct and language from the recent occurrence that we had with the school.
So you included it?
It wasn't specific enough, I guess.
So what did you modify?
We didn't modify anything yet.
Oh, we need to modify it.
Oh, you're saying it needs to be modified.
Right.
Well, modify it and bring it back to the board. And of course, you probably want to run it through the attorney.
Yep.
Present it back to us with the suggestions and we'll take a look at it. And
well, Maureen's not here, so she's the personnel committee.
I'm on the personnel committee.
Oh, you are? Oh, you are? You took over Charlene?
Sure.
Yep.
Okay. Well.
I'm kind of partly on that committee too.
Oh, good. Then two of you are here, then.
I'll take over for sure.
Well, I'm not trying to.
Yes, you are.
Take, no, I know. I'm not trying to take advantage of your background, but.
Oh, I don't. Well, I do some employment law now. But I'm happy to look through this and make my suggestions, and you guys can make your suggestions.
I think it only has to refer to the first two paragraphs of that page as it related to what occurred.
I don't know what these guys are thinking.
I would love your input.
I'll give my input next meeting.
All right.
So what, table? Just table it?
And I got your back.
Yeah.
Move the table to
Tenny until next month.
Yep.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Good. Committee reports, technical committee. We beat that for a while. Personnel committee?
Nothing.
Nothing. Commissioner comments?
None here.
Nothing.
Karen, nothing. I just want to say, Terry, good luck going forward.
Thanks.
And I did meet with the school board personally at their last meeting, and they were very appreciative, and the school district seems to, excuse me, want to brush this under the rug and move on.
Unfortunate.
Public comments, there's none.
I'll move to adjourn.
We have a motion.
Support.
It's been supported. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? We're adjourned.